Drawing and Talking, Gamergate Part 2 with Nathaniel Sullivan and Patrick. Let me ask you one thing, and I know you have to go in a second. That's great. So I'm also time-pressed. But I was going to ask you quickly. So is part of this growing pains for gaming? I mean, you're pretty into gaming. Is part of this, I mean, on the one hand, games are art, right? On the one hand, games seem to be art, but on the other hand, I mean, games, they're kind of like appliances, right? And when I see game reviews, there's a lot about like the controls and so forth and the gameplay and just kind of the raw mechanics. Is this kind of a community coming up against like the question of, is it going to be art or is it going to be an appliance or what exactly is it going to be?
Well, I mean, video games were, I mean, they were art long before we've even sort of had these arguments and conversations.
Right, but
as
if, but if,
as of now.
But if they're art, I mean, these are the kind of arguments you're going to have, right? I mean, this is just going to be part of it.
That's true, but at the same time, with these arguments, more so than ever now, are they're more semantic arguments than anything else that's really about. Like for instance, the argument as to whether or not a gamer should identify themselves as such, and other people feel. I guess they have this higher than thou attitude, as a saying that, you know, gamers, quote unquote, should be more nuanced adults and not refer to them as such, as saying, well, I am, you know, my name is Patrick, I work in such and such, and also I play video games, but I am not necessarily a gamer. That's not who I am. I don't identify myself by one single hobby in life. But what people fail to realize in that respect is that if you ask someone, you know, if they play games and they respond to you and they say that they're a gamer, it's more or less like a parlance for just saying that, yes, I play games.
Right.
You know, and the bet that most average gamers probably want nothing to do with the Gamergate argument at hand.
Right.
They have better things to do with their time.
Right.
But again, yeah, the argument as to where games are going is, as you said, it is a growing pain. It's going to continue to go on for, I mean, I couldn't even put a timestamp on how long it'll go on, because it's hard to even discern when all this began. But I guess that's just the evolution of the culture itself.
Yeah,
but I hope that as we get into the future, it won't be as argumentative.
Really? Because I wonder, one of the things that really strikes me about gaming, and this really kind of sets gaming apart, is you mentioned the doxing, the exposing of the documents online, and the involvement of fandom with the industry, with the games, with the social media. I mean, that seems to me so striking. That seems to me so, it's not unprecedented historically, but media traditionally has been so passive. I mean, you have a book, you have a newspaper, you read it, you can't really
answer
back.
Well, because of the social media presence, everything is so instant now, and everyone feels that what they say is gospel, and they have to get it out right then and there. Listen to me, pay attention to me, so I can get all the followers and have everyone heed my concerns and worries.
Okay, yeah, all right, that's something I'd not considered with it. Okay, all right, well, I know you have to go, we're coming up on 4 minutes, so thanks, and all right.
No problem.
Like and subscribe. Peace out.